Hello everyone, let's talk about communication in the Middle Ages. So in the Middle Ages, the importance of public speaking declined. This is because the political system was completely different from the classical era. Citizens had no say in the political process and they held very little political power. They could only rebel, but this was a very risky proposition given that the ruling elite, they were very powerful warriors. So, although rhetoric was taught in medieval universities, it was not as important as it had been in the classical times. This is because literacy rates had declined drastically since the fall of Rome. Few people could read or write, even among the ruling and the religious elite. So, as a result, written communication became really less widespread. Instead, oral and figurative forms of communication became very important. Town criers, architecture, statues, and religious art were all used to reach a larger audience. Coins were also a form of visual communication that conveyed messages about who was in power. These channels of communication were well suited for conveying messages about authority and obedience. The church played a major role in this. It often worked with the secular leaders to spread their messages. For example, you know, the rulers and the clergymen, they would often agree to share news about taxes, wars, and other important matters at the end of Sunday Mass. This was an effective way to reach a large audience as most people attended church regularly. So other forms of media also focused on oral and visual communication. Plays and theaters, they still existed, but they did not draw the same large audience as they had in the classical times. So here are some additional examples of how communication was used in the Middle Ages. Flags and banners were used to identify different groups and to communicate messages about military strength and political power. For example, there were flags for Crusades, Knight Templar, Holy Roman Empire, city-states of Italy, English and the French armies. Dance and music were also used to entertain people, but they could also be used to convey messages about religious beliefs or political propaganda. This included the church, the tubaros, the minstrels, mystery plays, courtly love tradition, celebrating festivals, and also to commemorate important events. Another form of communication was graffiti. It was used to express opinions or also to spread rumors. I, William, was here. This graffiti was found in a church in Norfolk, England, and it is thought to have been written by a monk. And it is a simple example of how graffiti was used to express personal identity. Next, here lies a thief. This graffiti was found in a cemetery in France. It is an example of how graffiti was used to mark territory or to communicate messages to others. The Bayeux tapestry is an embroidered cloth that tells a story of the Norman conquest of England in 1066. It is one of the most famous works of art from the Middle Ages and was used to communicate the events of the conquest to a wide audience. Body language was another way to communicate emotions and intentions. However, the way people communicated in Middle Ages was very different from the way we communicate today. The basic principles of communication are, of course, the same. Still use the oral, written, and figurative forms of communication to share information, ideas, and emotions.